My name is Jeff D'Amico. I'm the Onerous Project Manager from Compass Project Management. We're the lead on the project, helping guide the town and the project team all the way through. We're here today for an important major milestone, which is the groundbreaking. As you can hear and see behind me, there's a lot of activity. It's an exciting point in the project. Everything's real. We started 2 years ago with the building committee on a process of coming up with an idea of what a school would be, whether it was renovation or new. And here we are 2 years later, breaking ground and actually starting construction. So I'm going to give you a brief overview of the project itself, and then I'm going to turn it over to the chairman of the committee to have other remarks, and then pass it on to the subsequent speakers after that. So the new school in Hopkinton is a pre-K, kindergarten, and first grade early elementary school. It's a two-story building that's 82,000 square feet, roughly in the shape of a T. To orientate you to where we are, over my shoulder here, going this way, will be the main building. Starting in the back, closest to us, will be the cafetorium and the gymnasium, leading straight forward to the entrance to the building. And teeing off to the left will be the main classroom wing. And so all grades, first grade on the second floor and kindergarten on the lower floor, will be reaching out to the woods that way. Right where this major dirt pile is going to be the corner of the playing field. And behind me will be the playgrounds themselves. So just to orientate you, you're standing on an important thoroughfare, which is a pedestrian connection to the EMC park. So there'll be symbiotic relationships between the park there and the playing fields here for access so the community can build and work with each other for your shared uses. Another important note is that this project is going to be a LEED Silver project, so there's a lot of green elements in this building. Hopkinton wants to build for tomorrow and obviously be cognizant of the environment that we're in. The building has been designed by Drummy Roseanne Anderson, who's our project architect. With us are Judd and Jim from their office. And your construction manager is Colantonio Inc. They're the builders that will be helping us bring this project to fruition. With that, I'm going to turn it over to the chairman, Joe Markey, for some remarks. Thank you.
Thank you, Jeff. As the senior project manager from Compass, Jeff has done an outstanding job managing all the moving parts of this very complex project. Throughout the design phase, where thousands of pages of detailed documentation are created and forms, and keeping us all apprised of the risks and issues and offering his objective advice along the way. So thank you, Jeff, for all of your contributions to this. I'd also like to introduce Jim Barrett and his team from DRA Architects, including Judd Christopher, landscape architect David Warner, Chelsea Christensen, Niche Engineering, and we're so happy to be working with our construction partner, Colantonio Construction from Holliston, Mass. Welcome, everyone. We're so glad you can be here to celebrate this moment and witness this with us. I'm going to share some opening remarks and make some acknowledgments and introductions, and then I'll introduce each of the speakers in turn, who are so glad they could join us today. On this ground will be a school that will be the starting point of a lifelong journey of education for thousands of children. About 90 years ago, we could imagine that a similar group may have gathered at the Common to celebrate the first shovels hitting the ground at Center School. And the legacy that that moment has left, with generation after generation of children going through and up those stairs and through those doors over decades and decades, is just immeasurable, the impact. I want to acknowledge the youngest guests who are here today. We do have some preschool age children who actually be students at this school, so welcome to you. I think even more remarkable than the fact we're building a school for some of our preschool age children that are with us today is that we're really building a school for future generations of children who are not even here yet. We're building a school for our community's future, for children whose parents may not even be born yet, right? So we're really excited about the contribution that we're making to this community's future. And really, when you stop and think about that and the impact that we're having today for generations that will live and use this school long after many of us will no longer be here, is just really astounding. It makes me ask that question of, really, can there be any better measure of of a community's strength and cohesiveness than its willingness and determination to build something for future generations. And I want everyone to think about that, and it's a big deal. Make no mistake, to get here did require community determination and resilience. We picked up the baton from many who went before us. This has been an effort decades in the making. I want to acknowledge past chairs of committees who helped create the foundation for our committee that began 3 years ago. Andrew Wilgum, Rebecca Roback, David Hammaker, Gene Birchman, Dave Stolt, and the many others that they worked with over the past couple of decades to create the foundation that we're building on today. On that note also, I want to acknowledge and thank former Selectman Chairman Ben Palaco, former School Committee Chair Nancy Burdick for bridging the gap during a painful time of disappointment for Hopkinton from 2011 to 12. Instead of giving up, you worked hard through the lessons learned, fought hard to set up the governance structure to move forward, and you appointed the committee that I feel so privileged to have led these past 3.5 years. I'd like now to introduce that committee, the members of the Hopkinton Elementary School Building Committee, if you could please stand and be acknowledged. Center School Principal Lauren DeBow, Director of School Finance Ralph Dumas, and Superintendent of Hopkinton Schools Kathy McLeod. I'd also like to acknowledge Al Rogers, Director of School Buildings and Grounds, who's contributed so much of his expertise. From Town Hall on the committee, Hopkinton's Town Manager Norman Camallo and Town Engineer Dave Dalforio. Thank you for your advice and guidance throughout. I'd also like to acknowledge both the Superintendent and the Town Manager's extended staff, from their administrative staff to the permitting and town clerk and all the other functions across the school and town departments who helped us along the way. Also on the committee, I'd like to acknowledge Pam Waxlax. We can rely on Pam to read every line of every invoice, make sure everything adds up. Thank you, Pam. Rob Nickerson. Rob has done such an outstanding job on community engagement and communications. John Weaver. Here's a guy who builds hospitals and large buildings for a living and still finds time to volunteer for his community. We've learned so much from you, John. Thank you. John Graziano and Kelly Knight, both full-time jobs, nearly full-time jobs as volunteers on the school committee, and still made time to contribute so much to the Elementary School Building Committee project. Brendan Tedstone, a Center School alumni, who's stepping up to give back to his community as a recently elected selectman. Thank you, Brendan. I'd also like to acknowledge the past member from the Board of Selectmen, John Mosier, who's also here today. Thank you, John, for all your work. And finally, I'd like to introduce Mike Shepard, the Vice Chair of the Center School of this project, also a Center School alum and a grandfather of future students who will use this school. We're so grateful for Mike's investment in just about every time-consuming initiative where we've had to have one or more committee members step up for extra work beyond our regular scheduled meetings. Mike brings municipal expertise from his years as building inspector in Hopkinton and Brookline, as former Hopkinton selectman, and from past school building projects in Hopkinton. Thank you so much, Mike Shepard. So the governance that the selectman and school committee set up was important. The execution of this fabulous committee that has been working the past 3 years was very important. But when I stopped to think about the most important thing, in my opinion, that's finally gotten us to this groundbreaking today, it's been the will, the determination, the resiliency of this community. We're on this committee, and we feel that energy. It motivates us, and we've been channeling that energy to build this new school. And no one can be more excited about this new school than our first speaker, Center School Principal Lauren DeBow.
I am truly thrilled to be here. I am speaking on behalf of the Hopkinton Public Schools as our superintendent, who has been an incredible supporter of this project, is with her family welcoming twins. So that is certainly a reason to not be at this special presentation. So despite the weather, the wind, the rain, we are thrilled to be here. We are thankful for the enduring support to find a solution to the challenges of Center School. The community's journey And as you've heard, it has been quite a journey to find a solution is a testament to the steadfast perseverance of Hopkinton. We, the preschool, kindergarten, and first grade staff and students, will thrive in a facility specifically designed for early childhood education. This is incredibly exciting for us. Over the years, we have strengthened our flexibility and resiliency while we have built a learning foundation for young learners in limited space with expected as well as unexpected challenges. This week, we had some as well. The day is that much closer when these are not at the forefront requiring our attention and we can tend to the educational needs. This school is so much more than a building to us. It is an opportunity to enhance our approach to teaching and learning, an opportunity to do what we seek to do without constraint. This applies to student learning as well as adult learning. We are all continuous learners, refining our craft. For educators, this means a facility with the structural uniqueness to support early childhood education, while providing a facility conducive to professional development. For families, this means the ability to be welcomed into the Hopkinton Public Schools in a manner that you should be welcomed. Space for registration, space for parent trainings, space for meetings, the list is extensive. We value active learning both inside and outside. We will have playgrounds that promote a wide variety of active learning appropriate for our age levels. Preschool will have its first playground at school, as opposed to what is currently defined as a play space because it does not meet the criteria of a playground. That in itself is thrilling. Working together under one roof, the alignment of preschool through first grade will be strengthened. Our students will benefit tremendously. On behalf of the Hopkinton Public Schools, we cannot thank the community, our local representatives, the Elementary School Building Committee, and to the MSBA for making this project a reality. Thank you for the solution to Center School's challenges.
Thank you, Lauren. Next, I'd like to introduce the next speaker, Lori Nickerson from School Committee.
Good morning. I'm definitely overwhelmed by the crowd today. This was unexpected, but very, very indicative of the support that the town has shown for this project. As Joe said, I'm Lori Nickerson. I'm chairperson of the Hopkinton School Committee. I'm both honored and be with this esteemed group to celebrate the next phase of Hopkinton's investment in early education. This groundbreaking is a joyous occasion for both the school committee, Dr. McLeod, Mrs. DeBoe, and especially the hardworking members of the Elementary School Building Committee, all of whom have been personally involved in creating a critically needed school building that would best support the strategic initiatives the district has set for its youngest learners. For the Elementary School Building Committee, this day marks a significant milestone in a project that the ESBC began work on 3 years and 7 months ago, to the day, actually. Why do I know the exact date of the very first meeting of the ESBC? Well, yes, my husband's on the committee, but more importantly, our daughter was born that day. So 3.5 years later, here we are. And as our daughter has grown and successfully navigated her milestones over the past 3 years, this building project has grown and successfully achieved its milestones at both the town and state level. The new elementary school project we are celebrating today required leadership, foresight, careful planning, and extensive community involvement. In fact, community involvement has been the linchpin to the project's success. Whether it be community members of the ESBC who devoted countless hours to understanding the needs of our students and teachers, or the citizens themselves, each of you who voiced an opinion to help shape this project into the masterpiece it is today. I look forward to standing here with all of you upon successful completion of this project as we open the doors in September of 2018 and welcome our first preschoolers, kindergartners, and first graders to enjoy the fruits of your labor. And as hard as it is to believe, my pride will be doubled that day. both for the completion of a project that has been a long time coming for the town, as well as my pride in our youngest daughter embarking on her educational journey in a building created with the unique needs of our youngest learners in mind. Thank you.
Thank you, Lori, and thanks for your leadership as chair of the school committee. It's been such a pleasure working with the school committee and the Board of Selectmen, and just great communication both ways. They've empowered this committee to work as we needed to get the job done. And I'd like to introduce our next speaker, Brian Herr, the chairman of the Board of Selectmen.
Thanks, Joe. Good morning, everyone. I'm not nervous and shaking. I'm freezing and shaking. And I'm also glad I wore my brand new shoes today. My wife is going to be very pleased when I get home. Anyway, great to see you all. Thanks for coming out this morning. This has been a long time in coming. It's been mentioned a couple of times. We went through a couple processes to get to this point. We learned a lot along the way. And I think at the end of the day, when this thing opens in September of 2018, we're going to have a great school for our students. And they're going to get a great education here in Hopkinton. It's going to be great because we had a great process. The process that the Elementary School Building Committee followed, the process that the Board of Selectmen, the school committee, our professional teams put together is why we're going to have a great product. In the public sector, when you have a great process, you generally get a great result. In the public sector, when the process isn't so great, you generally have other kinds of results. I think there's plenty of examples where the process doesn't always go very smoothly. There's one before us right now at the national level that I won't comment on. But there's also been many examples when the process has been excellent. And when you have an excellent process, you have great volunteers working together to make things happen, you're gonna have a great product, a great result. What's going on behind us is the beginning of what will be a great school. It's because we have great volunteers and a great process. And I want to thank, on behalf of the community, all 17,000 residents, I want to thank the Elementary School Building Committee for a great job. And we really appreciate all your hard work. I also want to take a quick second and acknowledge once again Ben Palaco, the former chair of the Board of Selectmen, and John Mosier, my former colleague on the Board of Selectmen, for their work specific to this project, but also for all the work they've done in Hopkinton over the years. Thanks, guys, for coming out today, and appreciate all your work. Thank you all. Have a great day, and hope you all get warm here very soon. Thank you.
Thank you, Brian. Good job. Before I introduce the next speaker, I just want to point out this project was a partnership between the town of Hopkinton and the state of Massachusetts, in particular the Massachusetts School Building Authority. I want to point out, because when I mentioned that, a lot of people kind of stiffen up or roll their eyes, say, oh, you had to work with the state. I bet there was a lot of forms, a lot of process, a lot of bureaucracy. I want to correct that misperception. Working with the MSBA has been a partnership that has saved this town probably millions of dollars. It has created a process that's sound. It's created the right governance. Here's a group of people at the state level who've built dozens, if not hundreds, of schools. And they've got the collective experience to help advise communities like Hopkinton and help us avoid the common pitfalls that you imagine a volunteer committee trying to build a school without the expertise of the MSBA. So thank you to the Massachusetts School Building Authority for being a partner with the town of Hopkinton in this project. And with that, I'd like to introduce Jack McCarthy, the executive director of the MSBA.
Good morning. On behalf of Treasurer Goldberg and the rest of my colleagues at the Mass School Building Authority, thank you so much for allowing me to be part of this today. The mission of the Massachusetts School Building Authority is to partner, and you hear that word a lot today, but that's the first word in our mission statement. It's to partner with Massachusetts communities to support the design and construction of educationally appropriate, flexible, sustainable, and cost-effective public school facilities. And this project certainly will meet that ideal. Benjamin Franklin once said, an investment in education pays the best interest. We at the MSBA are proud to be your investing partners to the tune of 44.5% of eligible costs. And thank you for the kind words about the process, but I didn't write the statute, but I have two people down here that write statutes all the time, and I'm going to tell you something you already know, but you have the best legislative delegation in the state. When I first got to, yeah, please applaud. Sometimes now, I've had so many meetings with them on this project, that sometimes when I go to the State House, I automatically go to their office and I say, wait a minute, this is not why I'm here today. But they really showed some leadership in this when it first started. And you know, thank you for thanking us, but I need to thank them for their leadership on this. So thank you to Senator Spilka and Rep. Dykeman. Thank you. This project, you know, we do a lot of projects, but this project is one that really is important and special to me. And it's because of Nancy. When I first met Nancy and I saw her passion for the students here and passion for the projects, it really spoke to me and it really made me pay more attention than I normally would have. So thank you on behalf. So thank you. I want to congratulate the building committee. You have put together a great team with DRA, Compass, and Colantonio. I expect this project to be on time and on budget. Why? Because that's what they've done for me before. You guys have done a great job, and if just listening to Jeff at the beginning of this, you really realize what a quality individual, what a great OPM he is. And so I congratulate you folks for choosing such great consultants. So give yourself a round of applause for that. To paraphrase a Winston Churchill quote, in the beginning, we shape the school buildings. Thereafter, they shape us. And I think that's what you're going to find here with your new building. I can't wait to come back here in the fall of 2018 to cut a ribbon. Thank you very much.
Thank you again, Mr. McCarthy. Next speaker I'd like to introduce is someone who's been with us from the beginning. Every time we've had meetings at the MSBA, both of the next speakers have reached out and asked if they could help. And they have at every step of the way. I'm happy to introduce my friend and our state representative, Carolyn Dykema. Thank you, Carolyn.
Thank you, Joe. It's great to be here, and it's great to be here with my friend and colleague, Senator Spilka. And I have never been, I don't think, any happier to see active construction equipment than I am today, looking back to see what's going on here. Really a beautiful sight. And I know this has been a really long road for the community, so it's particularly sweet, again, to be here and see so many people coming out in support of this project. And I think more than so many other wonderful projects in town, this is really a labor of love and a project of, by, for the community and its future. And you look at the range of people in the audience who have participated in this process, which has been a lengthy one, a very deliberative one, and a very inclusive one, so that what you are going to have at the end of the day and what's represented in this beautiful picture is going to represent the best of Hockington. And while this is about a building in the most specific sense, I really think that this is about so much more, especially for a community like Hockington, which has some of the best schools in the state, is acknowledged by so many. Which has to do so much with the families here in town, with the teachers, with the folks who are willing to pay for beautiful new buildings like this. It really speaks to the values of this community and the value that you all put in education, in your children, in your families, in your future. That is really something worth celebrating. So it's great to see. Again, we don't have rain, and we actually had a little bit of sun this morning, so I think that's really appropriate. I want to echo the thanks to Jack McCarthy and the MSBA. Some of the best projects are the ones that we can feel good that we all work together in partnership, both at the local level as well as the state level. And it's great to be able to bring some of these state resources back to the community, which at the end of the day is a role that I know both the Senator and I relish and take very seriously. And this is one of those opportunities to bring the funds that we all know that we send into the state to then bring them back to our communities in a way that really makes a difference both today and tomorrow. I'm sure there are so many people in this audience that need to be recognized. Joe had a lengthy list at the beginning. I would like to recognize Joe Markey for his contributions as well. Clearly been very much a face of this project, very much a local advocate, passionate advocate. So thank you, Joe, and all who join you and have come before you in this effort. So without further delay, I would like to introduce my friend, Senator Spilka.
Thank you. Good morning. What a spectacular site to begin with. I have to say that this selection of this site alone is phenomenal. My father was a builder, so I grew up on job sites. So when I hear the banging of the big trucks and the diggers, it's like music to my ears. But knowing the history of this project, it's like a sonata. So I applaud all of you for all of your work. I also want to congratulate the school committee, the Board of Selectmen for helping to lead the way, both past and present, and the future that'll be there to help our kids. It's been a phenomenal experience. We know that this was a hard road. We know what happened in 2011. Jack is shaking his head. Because he has been such an incredible partner in this. When the vote first failed, he was one of the first persons to speak to say, okay, you got this is what you guys need to do. How many meetings did we have? It's really been a phenomenal experience. And the Elementary School Building Committee, congratulations to you, Joe, and all of the folks. Unless you've been on that kind of committee, you don't realize how many hours you really do put into this and the detail you go into. But this is a testament to what Hopkinton is about and what the folks and the residents of Hopkinton are. The fact that the vote failed, and I know sometimes somebody said to me, oh, don't mention that vote. Don't mention the 2011 vote. But what a phenomenal regrouping everybody did, and the building committee, the school committee, the meetings that took place to really pull people in. I mean, there were meetings almost every week to talk to people, to figure out what does this community need, what does this community want. And that's the basis for the building behind us. And that is a real testament to not only the town as a community, but to education and educating our kids and showing you can fail, but you can regroup, learn something from it, and come out with a product that's not only better than what the starting one was, but will help so many people and be successful and just be a phenomenal end result. So that is a lesson for all of our kids as well. And I just want to also applaud Hopkinton for taking a lead in the early childhood education. We know that by giving a strong foundation to our kids, we're helping them for the rest of their lives, and not only their generations, but their kids, giving them a strong path. So this is one of the first communities that I'm aware of that will have a school like the one that's being built here. So I applaud all of you for having the foresight, the vision, and the sense of community and the strength that Hopkinton stands for. So congratulations. And I'd like to invite my friend and colleague Carolyn back up, and Joe. We have a legislative citation. I will just read it, that it's congratulations to the Hopkinton Elementary School Building Committee in recognition of your joyous occasion of the groundbreaking for Hopkinton's new school, and that we wish you continued success and all the best. And here, it's yours. Congratulations. Thank you.
Thank you, Senator Spilka. Thank you, Carolyn Dykema. And thank you to everyone here. I'd like to hand it over to the Vice Chair of the Elementary School Building Committee, Mike Shepherd, for some closing remarks. But again, thank you all for joining us on this. It wasn't too cold at the beginning, but an hour into it, it feels a little cold. So thanks for staying with us. And with that, I'll hand it off to Mike Shepherd. Thanks, Mike.
This is what it's about.
My grandson, Beckett, my granddaughter, Harper, and Quinn, and another new granddaughter over there, Willa.
Microphone.
Harper will be going to the first grade in this school. She's going to be going to kindergarten. This will be going after. These are the reasons we built these schools. And Mike, it's been a long process. I'm really excited you all came out. And I really want to thank the people that came out to all our pre-construction meetings at the Senior Center, and the snow and the yucky weather. And your guidance is what helped us incredibly on this project, not only where it was going to go, but what it looked like. And it'll be an exciting project. And we want to thank you all for your help. before these two kids sit on this tent. We'll break for pictures and get some refreshments, and we thank you very much.
Thanks, Mike. As everybody alluded to, it takes an army to make this project a reality. It takes a village for all the kids to come here, so the town is very excited about it. As Mike noted, we do have some water and refreshments if you need it. There are porta-johns on the far side of the parking lot to keep out of the wind, maybe. But I invite all of you to come up, grab a shovel, grab a hard hat, and take some photo opportunities. So thank you all for coming, and enjoy your new school when it's ready for you.
Everybody grab some dirt. Okay. Don't. All right, so everybody look up. Smile.
Everybody pause for a moment. Look up. Oh, look at those smiles. Are you ready?
$1 million smiles.
And then on the count of three, we'll try to hit that guy with the camera. All right, but while you're throwing, keep smiling.
Two. Three.
I don't know, it was Robert Parr. Everyone put your dirt down.
We gotta do this.
Wet dirt.
Are you ready?
Three. Can we get a look and a smile over here, please? Go!
Full shovel. This is here. All right, on three, one, six, two, three.
Alright,
on three, one, two, three.
Kelly, that was really good. That was not a very good.
On three, one, two, three.
Good job. Right. Nice to meet you guys, fellas.